The sad part is, Alan, people don't realize the power, and that's why they can. That's why our job is that initial getting them to understand, look, if you put time and effort into this, this is what's going to happen.
Well, you know? Here's the thing, Al. You know, the easiest thing for somebody to do is nothing.
Right? There you go.
The path of least resistance is to just do nothing different. So here's the thing. Most people, just humans, will act faster to eliminate something that's negative than they will to get something that's positive. So if I said to you, Al, you know what? You should probably replace your fire extinguishers. You've had them for 5 years, okay? And you're like, yeah, okay, right? But if you had a fire, right? Or let's say there was a fire in the building next door. Are you going to go replace your fire extinguishers now?
Yeah.
Right?
You bet your ass I will.
Right. But that's the thing is, because the loss of revenue, that you can't see it, right? You can't see lost revenue. That DJ that lost that wedding saw a $5,000 loss because the people wouldn't even contact him, and the planner called him and said, hey, they wouldn't even contact you because of your website. So he knew. Now, here's the question. How many other people looked at his website and left without contacting him? Right?
Probably a lot.
So here's the question for everybody listening. The opportunity cost of not investing in your own time, your services, my services, whatever. Read a book, right? Just go read a book on Google AdWords. Get your Google local page, right? Your local business page, all that kind of stuff. Get all this set up. The cost of not doing it is how many lost sales. So I did something, was it last year? No, the year before. I do marketing every year for sales training. And I do it to a very small group. I have 17,000 people on my email list, but I'll market to about 100, 150 people to bring me in for sales training. Because remember, I only need a certain amount. So out of that 150, I'm trying to get 3, 4, 5 people maybe that would hire me. So I did something called the opportunity cost worksheet. And the opportunity cost worksheet was a postcard. And it said, you're losing sales. Every business is losing sales at every one of the 4 steps in the sales process. Getting the inquiry, getting their attention, getting the inquiry, having a conversation, making the sale. Okay? Everybody's losing. We all lose. I lose, you lose, everybody loses, right? But I wanted them to figure out how much they were losing. So I made this worksheet up and I said, figure out how much you're losing. And I said, here's it. What's your average sale? And I had them put that number in. And then it said at the first step of getting their attention, how many people are you losing by not having your ads in the right place, yada, yada. How many people are you losing by not getting the inquiry? How many people are you losing by not having a better conversation? How many are you losing by not closing the sale? And to make it so that they could figure exactly how much they were losing, I put this calculator in a box with that worksheet, and I mailed it to businesses so that they could physically, tangibly feel how much you mean I need a calculator to figure how big this number is, right? And it's one of these
that's
cool
a good idea of your end.
And this is one of these cool little calculators where you push the little thing and it pops open, stands itself up. But this, the idea was I wanted people to feel the pain. Feel the pain, and you're like, wait a minute, I need a calculator. That number is so big. Yeah, you know what? You're losing, everybody listening. You, me, everybody listening here is losing sales. For some reason, whatever the reason is, right? Somebody goes to my website, doesn't like it for whatever reason, or the worst reason is somebody looks at the cost, but doesn't look at the opportunity cost. So your services, if I don't get my Google listings the right way, if I don't do Google ads, if I don't do all that, I'm going to save the cost of hiring you. I'm going to save the cost of those ads. Okay, that's a finite number. That's this much.
Yeah.
But if I do it, how much can I earn? Right? That's an unknown. But the finite number is you're going to charge me X. Google's going to charge me X. Therefore, it's going to cost me X. Well, yeah, but how much could I make? If my average sale, if I need 1 sale to make that work, 2 sales to make that work, but I could get 3, 4, 5, right? When I did this mailing, I don't have one here. I did a custom box. The boxes cost $6 just to print the box, and then the calculator, and then the postcard, and then the postage and all that. I'm in for like $15 a piece. And people are like, $15 to mail one? Yeah. Yeah.
They don't look at the lifetime value. They only look at, oh, I'm spending $1, $2 a click, $5 a click. But yeah, you know, you realize when you're running ads and you bring clients in, what's that lifetime value? The lifetime value could be $2,000. I was like thinking to myself, my catering business, my client's lifetime value was averaging from 1,500 to 2,000. That's right. A huge number, right? Because one client usually spent 1,500, because I would go after corporate. I'm talking about corporate clients now.
Sure. Yeah.
And they're consistent. Every year they would call me. So I started calculating that. I'm like, so what? I spent $300 to buy this customer, but this customer made me $3,000-$4,000 because of the lifetime that they're going to be with me, maybe even a little bit more.
What about the friends? What about the people that were
exactly
there?
What about that? Exactly. You can't really get to that number, but just realizing, let's say 4,000, you know?
Right.
And when you change your mind, I mean, another thing is, like, I'm not saying just go advertise, spend money. No, it doesn't work because I've done it.
Right.
You have done it. It doesn't work. You have to test and measure. You have to test and measure. You have to know which ones are working. You ask the client, like you said in one of your books, you ask people. You ask, how did you find us? How did you, you know? But when you do Google ads, when you do Facebook ads that I'm running, you do YouTube ads, you can see the links, how many people click. All that data is there, so your mind can be at ease and say, look, it's working. Maybe you need to work on your website. You're getting the clicks, but they're not calling you because you're all over the place. Your website is all over the place. You're doing wedding here. You're doing funerals at the same page. And you're like, you brought that up. That was interesting. You don't want to market that together, maybe on a different page, right?
Right, or a different site altogether.